Hi, in this new video we will learn how to use snap to rotate and scale objects without the need to install any third-party plugin. Let's say I want to rotate this box around this vertex. The first thing I want to do is to lock this object. So I press the spacebar on the keyboard. As you can see here, the lock icon is pressed. You can use also this button here. Now the trick here is that when you lock an object, you cannot select any other object in the scene. But at the same time, you can still use the snap feature anywhere in the scene. So the second thing I want to do, I will right click the snap and choose the snapping mode I want. In this case, I will choose the vertex. Now I need to turn on the snap. The second thing, I need to change this option here from use pivot point center to the second option, which is use selection center. Now I will click the rotate and I will move my mouse here. As you can see, the snap flashes, the vertex snap flashes here. So I click and start dragging. Now I'm rotating around the Z axis. If I want to change it to the Y axis, for example, I can press the F6 while I'm still dragging, or F5 to rotate around the X axis. Now, if I like to rotate this box around a point on its surface, I can do that also. And this way, I don't have to change the position of the pivot point. I can click here, for example, and start rotating. I will press the F6. To use the Y axis or the F7, I can choose this point here, F6, F5. Also, I can press the A on the keyboard or click here to turn on the angle snap. This way, I can rotate with a predefined preset. Let's say by default it's 5 degrees increment. So now, as you can see, I'm rotating by 5 degrees increment. Now, of course, you can now right click and experiment with the different modes of snaps. For example, the midpoint of a segment, I can rotate around the midpoint of this segment, or the mid of this segment. You can experiment with the different kind of snaps. For the scale, it's the same thing. Lock the object, turn on the snap, make sure use selection center. Now click the scale. Now let's say I want to scale starting from this point here. As you can see, I don't have to change the pivot point. Also, if I change the scale from uniform to the second option, which is select and non-uniform scale. Now, let's say I want to scale starting from this point in the X direction. I can click here, and now it's using the Z axis. So I will press, while I'm dragging, I will press the F5. So now I'm scaling starting from this point in the X axis. I can press the F6, F7. I can use a point on a different object for the F7, F6, F5. I can choose this point here for the F5, for the X axis, F6 and F7. And basically that's it. Now you can go and start practicing, use it in try it with different scenarios. It's very useful. And that's it for this video. Hope you like it. If you like it, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel, and see you next time. Thank you.